On the 7 News Health Report this afternoon, the growing problem of eczema. It's a condition that often starts when we're very young and can progress to asthma. Now, eczema is also known as dermatitis. It affects up to 30% of Australian children. They get dry, red and itchy skin, usually in the crease of the elbow or the back of the knee, as well as on the face as well. Now, spring can be one of the worst times for eczema when allergies cause it to flare up. And the causes are linked to family history, also the environment, including, Mel, over-cleaning.
Oh, might relax on the cleaning then. Being too clean, though, was a finding in a recent study of almost 11,000 British children. So let's check in with dermatologist Dr. Anne-Marie Cazidlow, who joins us live. Nice to see you.
Thank you, Mel.
Can we all relax on the cleaning? Is this one of the problems? Kids in clean homes have eczema?
Well, we can be a little easy on ourselves. I suppose that the important thing to understand is that with regards to eczema, there's actually been an increase in the incidence, particularly in the last 30 years and in industrialised countries. And there have been a number of theories as to why this is the case. One such theory is what we call the hygiene hypothesis. And the hygiene hypothesis suggests that if we overclean our children and our environment, that we aren't being exposed to bacteria and organisms, and as a result, our children's immune systems aren't developing in a balanced way.
Okay, but there's a difference between Is there a difference between sort of dirt and being unhygienic? I'm not going to leave the dishes in the sink and, you know, that kids get sick, but they've got to go outside and play in the dirt a bit, don't they?
That's right. So the important thing is just to use a practical, sensible approach. Let your children go out and play in the backyard, run around in the dirt and in the garden. Let them interact with their pets. And I think a really important thing also is to not over-sanitise and use a lot of antibacterial products in the home, which we tend to do nowadays.
Mm. What do you do if, I mean, the pictures we were just showing there were clearly extreme examples, and I'm sure those kids are being treated by doctors. What if you've got a child with a mild case or a medium case? What's the best advice?
Well, look, the important thing is that to understand is that eczema is actually a genetic condition. So we can't actually cure it, but we can actually maintain that skin barrier. And there are times that, you know, patients don't have a flare in their eczema, and we would like them to get their parents to manage their skin in order to prevent flare-ups. And what we advise them to do is three things. Essentially, have short warm showers and baths rather than the use of hot water, as this tends to dry the skin. Use a soap-free and fragrance-free products at all times, and that includes washes. And also the liberal and frequent application of a good moisturizer, something like Cetaphil, which will actually maintain that skin barrier and help to prevent eczema flares.
Anne-Marie, great advice. Really practical. Thank you. Nice to talk to you.
Thank you, Mel.
Enjoy the weekend.
You too.
Well, the day's top stories are next on 7's